In a little cafe, just the other side of the border. He was sitting there giving me looks that made my mouth water. So I started walking her way.
Hey everybody, welcome back. I am very pleased to bring you this video of a glitch that I discovered with Flak. It may very well work across the various Vault Hunter characters, but I've only confirmed it for Flak. At the moment, there's another video out there sort of applying what I'm doing to Amara. So the process was a little bit different, what that person was doing than what I was doing with Flak. But that leads me to believe that this might be something that you can do across the board. But for today's purposes, I'm just going to be showing you it in regards to Flak. As I'm sure you were able to glean from the intro of the video, this is an action skill cooldown glitch, and it allows you to have essentially instantaneous cooldown. With Flak, I'm sure you could see the possibilities. If you are familiar with his Fade Away and the Guerrillas in the Mist perk, you can just abuse the hell out of this and be cloaked basically all the time. Enemies can't hurt you, you're able to deal critical damage towards them, your DPS goes up enormously, and like I said, you basically just can't take any damage. I discovered this accidentally while playing with a friend. It just sort of happened. I noticed that I was able to cast my rack instantaneously, the rack attack, and that led me to try to then backtrack and figure out what I had done in order to activate that, because then when I tried it with Fade Away, I was getting basically instantaneous cooldown with Fade Away as well. So I thought, holy crap, I need to figure out how I did this and let the world know. So let's dive into how you do this. The method that you're going to be doing involves respeccing, so you are going to need some money of some sort. If you have a lot of money, this might cost you more, because you're going to have to respec multiple times, and the more money you have, the more it costs to spec. So I'm on a lower level character here. The amount that I'm spending per respec is not as much, but if you have gotten to the end of the game, money's probably not a problem for you. Probably have millions just sitting around doing nothing. But if you are in need of some money, I would just recommend that you need to be picking up more weapons and selling them. That's the easiest way I found to just make sure you always have enough money. So what you're going to be doing is you're going to be putting at least one skill point into one of your skill trees, just so that when you go to respec, it doesn't tell you that you can't do it. So you just put one or two points in, doesn't matter where. Activate your pet, activate your gamma burst. For my purposes, I'm just doing the skag. I don't think it matters which one. Make sure you select gamma burst, then go out of here, cast gamma burst, go back to the respec machine and respec while the skill is still active. Once you do that, if you open up your menu again and try to activate a different action skill, it'll say error, action skill is already in use. And if you just leave that for a while, it won't go away. So this bug that you get when you can't activate, you can't select a new action skill, the way you can fix this is you just fast travel. So for my purposes, I'm going to and from Athenas. This is where I discovered I had the glitch, and it's an easy, quick place to fast travel to because there's only one area on it. So fast travel to a location, and when you do, if you open up your menu again, you'll notice now that that bug is gone, and you can indeed select a different action skill. Well, what that has done, I've discovered, is that reduces your cool time. I don't necessarily know how it does it. I don't really care. All I know is that it does. And if you stack this and you go back, fast travel back to Sanctuary, cast Gamma Burst, respec, travel to another planet, come back to Sanctuary, just rinse and repeat. Each time you do it, you'll notice that your cooldown gets less and less. And the more you do it, the closer you can get it to near instantaneous. I did it to about 2 to 3 seconds for the Guerrillas in the Mist. That's just as far as I was going to go. I'm guessing you could get to 1 or 0. I just didn't do it because I wasn't willing to sacrifice quite all my money for this character. I'm doing a different playthrough with him, and I got it good enough for my purposes. Having 1 to 2 seconds, I mean, you have to reload somehow, and by the time I was done reloading, the skill was already recharged. And that's it. It's really simple. Like I said, all you have to do is have the money to do this, and if you have the money, just be willing to sacrifice some cash for this. One thing I will say, I do have Guardian perks unlocked, and they transfer across characters. One of the perks you get for that is that when your shield is active, your cooldown rate is increased. I'm uncertain if this is a bug that's related to the Guardian ranks. I don't have a character that doesn't have it because all my stuff is tied to it. But what I did do for purposes of this video, I made sure I didn't have any equipment that modified my cooldown time, and I actually took off the shield that I had on to make sure I wasn't getting the Guardian rank bonus. I'm assuming you don't get that bonus if you have no shield on. Maybe you do. I do know for certain that with my Guardian cooldown rate and the points that I put into my action cooldown rate, there was no way that that was making this instantaneous. I only have like 10% put in there or something, and I did test it. You know, if you quit out of the game, you lose this, so you have to then reset it. It's only active for that current session. So I did quit out, and I had a base level for what my normal cooldown was, and I was able to compare that to when I did this glitch. So the glitch does work. I'm just not entirely certain if maybe it's only something you can do when you unlock Guardian ranks. That's something I would like to know from you guys. If you haven't unlocked them and you tried this, let me know in the comments if it works for you. That is it. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you can make use of this before it's patched. As I said, I didn't see a whole lot around the internet at all on this, Reddit included. YouTube, I didn't see anything on this. I seen the one video. Like I said, that was it. That was specifically related to Amara, and I didn't see any just posts anywhere. I wasn't getting any hits when I Googled this. So I would make use of this as quick as you can before it will undoubtedly get patched. If it gets known out there to Gearbox, undoubtedly they will be patching this as soon as they can because it is extremely overpowered. I could see this as a very viable way. If you have a maxed out flat character, you could easily farm like the Slaughter 3000 events, especially the one on Pandora, and just make crazy use of this to get your legendary farming just to the next level, or just even farming bosses too. So have fun with this, share it with those you know, let them know about it so that they can make use of this before it gets patched. If you enjoyed the video, I'd really appreciate if you could smack that like button. As I said, share it with others. Consider subscribing for more videos like this. I got some other things coming out that's going to be really cool in the next week or so. You do not want to miss it. Thank you all again, and I'll see you in the next installment.